In 1955, the Sutton family of Hopkinsville, Kentucky, reported a close encounter unlike anything Ben has ever heard of before. They claimed that late one summer night, their friend Billy Ray witnessed a UFO land on the property before numerous aliens emerged from the woods and attacked their farmhouse. The Suttons responded by engaging in a firefight with the creatures.
Hurry up!
This family, after 4 hours of fighting off these creatures, they all pile into their trucks and speed into town to go to the police. These are people who take care of themselves. These are people who reach for their gun when there's trouble.
Right.
They don't go to the police.
Right.
So imagine you are the desk sergeant at the police department that night. 11 o'clock at night, two pickups come racing into the parking lot, skidding to a stop. 11 people go inside and report that a UFO, a flying saucer, has landed behind their house and that they've been attacked by little creatures. 16 law enforcement officers, the local police, the county sheriff, the state police, they all send people to the farm to see what they can find. And they find lots of evidence that this shootout really happened. There are holes in the screens, there's shot embedded in the window frames, there are shell casings scattered all over the ground, and one more piece of evidence was that there was a bald spot in the grass in the gully behind the farmhouse. Now, this is where Billy Ray had first seen the object float down from the sky and land on the ground. There was a bald patch there that nobody ever investigated.
Well, that's something to follow up on, definitely. Anything that could possibly be still there as far as physical evidence, because it sounds like military, the law enforcement, botched it.
It just raised too many tough questions, questions they just didn't want to deal with.
But you're telling me the police took it seriously, they came there, yet they didn't really do an investigation. The military shows up. What did the military conclude? Was the Air Force or Blue Book then involved after this?
The Air Force's involvement in this case is totally schizophrenic. They were all over this case, but publicly, they had no interest.
Wow.
In addition, and this is what the Air Force doesn't want you to remember, in addition, there were four military policemen from Fort Campbell, which was about 20 miles away. They were there almost instantly. There were also two men, two agents from a government agency that was never named, but they were wearing civilian clothes. But these two men showed up the day after the sighting and started asking a lot of questions. Nobody knows who they were. Nobody knows who they represented or who they worked for. But they were on the scene asking questions. So it's just one more layer of government involvement that they were desperately trying to cover up.
The Sutton family farmland is now in the possession of Geraldine's sister, Glenda. She has agreed to allow Ben to continue his investigation on her property.
Hello.
Hello.
Glenda, is it?
I'm Glenda.
Ben, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Ben.
The alleged landing spot of the UFO is just over 300 feet from the old Sutton farmhouse. It's said to be down a ravine and hidden deep in an overgrown patch of forest. Ben aims to leave no stone unturned in his quest to find it.
Well, if we turn this, like, this way, okay, so here's the railroad track.
Right.
So I'm imagining most of the shooting's gonna happen in this direction.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Out towards the back.
Yes, exactly.
But if you look here, it says it's up to 300 feet backwards is the gully where they believed that the object may have landed. I wonder if we could locate where this gully might be.
I think so. We can try.
Okay. Well, they were estimating the object supposedly landed about 300 feet from the house, so a football length back. If we go back there and go around, I bet you that will place us right there.
I believe so.
Are you up for an adventure?
We're up. Let's do it.
Okay, I could use your help. So this is the back side of the property where it ends.
Yes.
Here's the fence. Can I see the map for a second? Now, according to the memory of when they drew this, about 300 feet from the house, the object supposedly landed in a gully. So I'd actually like to measure this. I've got a tape measure here. We can measure back from the house, and that would put us a lot closer. So we'll just kind of lay it out, kind of back towards that way. One of you could maybe hold this for me.
Gotcha.
By measuring 300 feet from the farmhouse, Ben can determine where exactly the aliens emerged from the forest. If any evidence of the landing remains, it should be around that part of the woods.
Well, that's about 300 feet. So from the back to the house right here, yeah, it matches up with the map. I want to take a look at it, though, to see where that place is in the forest. So we're really close. I mean, this is practically 300 feet. So my estimate, if this map is, you know, close to real scale, is that there probably is that depression somewhere in here, just a little bit further north.
If Ben can find the depression where the craft landed, it could be proof that the Sutton story was true.
Are you guys up for going in there to check it out?
Sure.
Hey, watch your step.
And how skinny the little trees and stuff are. I see how brown it is, and there's not as much growing out there compared to everywhere else.
Geraldine has located a clearing in the woods without any old growth trees. Could this have been where the craft landed?
Well, these are definitely new trees. I think we're in it. Hold on. Are you seeing what I'm seeing? This is a patch of bare earth that looks a lot like what Bill described.
It looked like somebody had literally shaved the grass off the clay.
The circular patch of exposed soil doesn't match anything in its surroundings. And Ben can find no sign of what could have caused such an odd circle to form here naturally. Ben believes he could have found the location of the UFO's alleged landing. Now he wants to scan the old growth trees in the area. If this was the direction the Suttons were shooting, bullets might still be embedded in the trees.
These trees should have no metal in them unless somebody shot them. Oh, what was that?
Incredibly, Ben detects signs of metal in the trees. Potentially bullets covered by decades of growth. Between the discovery of the depression, the cleared ground, and the positive scans on the trees, the Sutton story could be plausible. But it's getting dark.
I have a flashlight. You guys don't. Mm-hmm. I'm just going to go a little further in.
Okay.
Are we good?
Sounds great.
You know your way out?
Yes.
If I'm not out in like another hour, send someone in. With guns, please.
Though the light is fading fast, Ben searches for more physical evidence from the craft, or the creatures themselves.
Is that us?
Nope.
You guys didn't do that? You didn't hear that? You guys can stay there. I just gotta look. There's something huge over here. That's probably as far as I can get. It's getting dark. There's something in there.
Just make your way back to us.
Okay. Coming back. I went back as far as I could go and had to stop because there's something big walking around in there. I want to ask the ladies if there's bear in this part of Kentucky because it's not a deer. It may have nothing to do with this case, but I think we better call it a night. And I think we came really close, if not actually found, the place where the craft allegedly landed.